How are you? Very good. Now this is part 44. In this part, I'm going to explain about inverse trigonometrical function. Inverse means trigonometry function. Clear? First of all, we have to note down few function and its principal value. Like y is equal to sin inverse x. Its principal value is minus pi by 2 is less than or equal y is less than or equal pi by 2. Means when we will find the value of sin inverse x, the answer will be lies between minus pi by 2, means the value of this function is more than equal to minus pi by 2 is less than equal to pi by 2. Understood? And y is equal to cos inverse x, its principal value is 0 is less than equal to y is less than or equal to pi. And y is equal to tan inverse x, its principal value is minus pi by 2 is less than y is less than pi by 2. Y is equal to cot inverse x, 0 is less than y is less than pi. And y is equal to sec inverse x, 0 is less than y is less than equal to pi, and where y is not equal to pi by 2. And last function is y is equal to cosec inverse x, and minus pi by 2 is less than equal to y is less than equal to pi by 2, and y is not equal to 0. Understood? Because all the inverse trigonometrical function have its domain, range, principal value, but here we have to know about the only principal value of all the inverse trigonometrical functions: sin inverse x, cos inverse x, tan inverse x, and cot inverse x, sec inverse x, and cosec inverse x. And you have to learn this much. With the help of this principal value, we can do maximum question of this chapter. Understood? Okay, I'm going to give example. Example means, suppose question number 1. In question number 1, tan inverse 1 plus cos inverse minus 1 by 2 plus sin inverse minus 1 by 2. Evaluate this value. Clear? Yes, it means in this question we have to find the principal value. Principal value. Then here, one by one going to find here. Tan inverse 1 is equal to suppose theta. Tan theta is equal to 1. Means tan theta is equal to tan 45 degrees. Theta is equal to pi by 4. Now we can say for tan minus pi by 2 plus pi by 2 means 5 pi by 4, this is a lies between this. It means here pi by 4 plus let cos inverse minus 1 by 2 is equal to theta, then cos theta is equal to minus 1 by 2. Now cos theta is equal to minus cos 60 degree, cos 60 1 by 2, cos theta is equal to cos minus 60 minus cos theta, and cos what? In the second quadrant, cos 180 minus theta is equal to what? Minus cos theta, and cos 180 plus theta is equal to minus cos theta. Clear? Then here, two value only. Minus cos 180 minus theta lies second quadrant. Second quadrant, cos is negative side. Cos 180 plus theta, this is lying the third quadrant. Then minus cos theta, it means minus cos 60 degree, we can write two times. Cos 180 minus 60, cos 180 plus 60 degree. Now we have to say from cos 0 to pi means less than equal to pi, we can't take this value. We can take this value, clear? It means cos theta is equal to what? Cos pi, 180 means pi minus pi by 3. Cos 3 pi minus pi, 2 pi by 3. And cos theta, now theta is equal to what? 2 pi by 3. Clear? 2 here, pi by 3. Understood? Now, we have to find this value. Sin late here, sin inverse minus 1 by 2 is equal to theta. Sin theta is equal to minus 1 by 2. And sin theta is equal to minus sin 30 degree. Sin theta is equal to sin minus 30 and sin 180 plus 30 degree. Both are negative sign. Sin minus theta minus sin theta. Sin 180 plus theta minus sin theta. Now we have to check for sin minus 90 plus 90. Minus 90 to plus 90. It means we can't take this value. We can take this value. And theta is equal to what? Minus pi by 6. Clear? 30 means pi by 6. Pi by 6. Now we can solve here. Pi by 4 plus 2 pi by 3 minus pi by 6. Understood? Now, we have to take LCM here. 12, 3 pi plus 8 pi minus pi by 6 is equal to what? 11 pi by 12 minus pi by 6. Now LCM is 12, 11 pi and here minus 2 pi. Understood? Now 11 pi by 12 minus pi by 6. LCM of 12 and 6 is 12. 11 pi minus 2 pi is equal to 11 minus 2 pi means what? 9 pi by 12 is equal to 3 pi by 4. Now this is answer. Are you understanding? Very simple. First of all, this is very important for you. You have to note down, learn about function its principal value. After that, if any question is there, suppose here 10 inverse 1, find the principal value of 10 inverse 1. Its principal value is pi by 4. Cos inverse minus 1 by 2, its principal value is 2 pi by 3. And sin inverse minus 1 by 2, its principal value is minus pi by 6. Then, taking LCM, by calculations, we can calculate at last 3 pi by 4. This is the value of first question. Understood? Clear? Okay, question number 2, evaluate 10 inverse under root 3, sec inverse minus 2, cosec inverse 2 by under root 3. Understood? Clear? Okay, now let 10 inverse root 3 is equal to theta. And here 10 60 degree. Theta is equal to pi by 3. We can check. 10 means minus 90 to plus 90. Here 60, it is a possible. Pi by 3. Minus sign. Second here, lit. Minus 2 is equal to theta. Sec theta is equal to minus 2. Sec theta is equal to what? Cos 60 is equal to 1 by 2. Then sec 60 is equal to 2. Now we have to check. Then this is a what? Sec 180 minus 60. And sec 180 plus 60 is equal to minus theta. Understood? For say 0 to pi means we can't take this value. थीटा इज इक्वल टू पाई माइनस पाई बाई थ्री, थ्री पाई माइनस पाई टू पाई बाई थ्री. वॉट इज अ प्रिंसिपल वैल्यू ऑफ सेक इनवर्स माइनस टू, दिस इज टू पाई बाई थ्री, देन हियर टू पाई बाई थ्री प्लस. नाउ लेट कोसेक इनवर्स टू बाई अंडर रूट थ्री इज इक्वल टू थीटा, therefore cos theta is equal to 2 by under root 3. Then here cos x degree theta is equal to pi by 3. Then here pi by 3. It means this is a principal value of tan inverse root 3 and 2 pi by 3 is the principal value of sec inverse minus 2 and pi by 3 is the principal value of cos inverse 2 by root 3. Then with the help of this rule, this value, we can find all the principal value of all different trigonometrical inverse functions. Then pi by 3 minus 2, pi by 3, pi by 3 is equal to what? Pi by 3, pi by 3, 2 pi by 3 minus 2, pi by 3 is equal to what? 0. Clear? Now 0 is the answer. Any problem? Very good. We have so many formula of inverse trigonometrical functions, but I'm going to prove here. First one, sine inverse x plus and cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Clear? We have to prove sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2 for all x belong to minus 1 comma 1. Understood? Now, let from this formula we can take any one value, either sine inverse x or cos inverse x. I am going to take sine inverse x. Sine inverse x is equal to theta. Therefore, sine theta is equal to x. Understood? Now, this sine theta we have to change into cos. Cos 90 minus theta is equal to x. 90 minus theta is equal to cos inverse x. Understood? Now 90 minus theta is equal to what? Sin inverse x is equal to cos inverse x. Now 90 is equal to sin inverse x plus cos inverse x. Therefore sin inverse x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Now this is a formula. Understood? Very simple. Tan inverse sin inverse x plus cos inverse is equal to pi by 2 for all x belong to, x is the elements of minus 1 comma 1. Then we can take sin inverse x or cos inverse x. Sin inverse x is equal to theta. Sin theta is equal to x. Now there is cos. Then we have to change into cos x. Sin 90 means sin cos 90 minus theta sin theta, and cos inverse x is equal to 90 minus theta. Now put the value of theta is equal to sin inverse x. 90 minus sin inverse is equal to cos inverse. 90 is equal to sin inverse x plus cos inverse x. Now this is the value. And in this way, similarly, we can put prove sin of x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2. And sin cos tan cot sec inverse x plus cosec inverse x is equal to also pi by 2. Understood? If we can prove sin of x plus cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2, then also we can prove tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2, and where for all x belong to a real number. Understood? X belong to real number. And for all here, x belong to r minus minus 1 comma. Then tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2 for x belong to r, and sec inverse x plus cosec inverse x is equal to pi by 2 and x belong to R minus minus 1 comma 1. In this way we can prove all the remaining formula, second formula and third formula. Understood? Okay. And now I'm going to give the homework question, because we have to do few question which is depending on this formula. Then homework question, find the value of following: cos inverse minus 1 by 2 plus 2 sin inverse 1 by 2. Second is cos inverse minus root 3 by 2. Third is sec inverse minus root 2 sin inverse sin 2 pi by 3. And fifth formula is, fifth question is sec inverse 6 given pi by 6. In this way, first of all, please, you will complete your this homework question, means video question. How many questions are given in video? And after completing this question, please, you will complete example, whatever example inside your syllabus. Please, you will complete example question. After completing example, you have to complete exercise question. And revision also important. After completing example and exercise, please, you may start the revision. Understood? Okay, thank you very much.